Good morning, dear friends. Today we are going to learn chapter 3, gender. What is gender? Gender is a system of differentiating nouns and pronouns as one of the following. So let us understand what is gender. There are four types of gender: masculine, feminine, common, neuter. In the noun we have learned about various types of nouns, but here we are going to differentiate this noun between under these four things. So masculine, feminine, common and neuter. Masculine is the having a male quality, feminine is having a female qualities, common it is both man and woman, or we can say male and female, whereas neuter is representing the non-living things. I once again repeat this, neuter is, we are trying to tell here the non-living things, which are things, correct? It could be anything that represents the non-living thing. For example, pain. We cannot differentiate pain into a male or female. So now, let us understand what is masculine gender. Masculine gender, a noun or pronoun that refers to a male character or member of a species. I repeat myself here, a noun or pronoun that refers to a male character or member of species. Here I am trying to give more stress on male character. So in the noun we have learned proper noun and common noun. If you see the first line in the example, boy, man, brother, bull, that comes under a common noun. But here when we are trying to be specific with their gender, so these things come under a masculine gender. Why? Because they are representing a male qualities, him, lion, actor, king, hero. Whenever you read these words, in your mind, automatically the things come of a male category. When we say king, you come to know who is the king, correct? You are not representing, you are not thinking about a queen over here. Hero, correct? We have role models, correct, as a heroes in our lives. So, they are representing as a male quality. Do you understand? Example also we can see it later on, but here example I can give you a dog, correct? When we see a dog, we come to know it is a masculine gender. So once again I am telling you here, masculine gender means the male character of member of species. Have you understood what is masculine gender? Very good. So what is the helpful link I have given here? The M's represents a masculine. So that is whenever you see in the exercise and all, it will be as M as masculine. Now let us move towards the another gender, that is feminine gender. Feminine gender, a noun or pronoun that refers to a female character or member of a species. I repeat here, a noun or pronoun that refers to a female character or member of a species. Now if you read those words, correct, you will come to know we are talking about female. Girl, woman, she, sister, cow. As we have said, a noun or pronoun. So what are the pronouns over here in this example? You can see she and her. These are the two pronouns which tells us something about a female character. So what is the helpful hint over here? We have put F as a female. If a noun has a suffix ending E-double-S-I-N-E or E-double-T-E, so that means it becomes a feminine. Example here you see, lioness, actress, heroine. So whenever we use this suffix that we have learned already in our fourth standard, suffix and prefix. So most of the suffix which ends in es, ine or ette, that is mean it is regarding the feminine gender. So lioness, actress, queen, heroine, these are all representing the feminine gender. Do you understand? We will also learn this in our example that I will show you what exactly the masculine and feminine genders are. So now let us see what are the masculine and feminine gender with the help of this example. You can see here father represents as a masculine and feminine mother, son, daughter, brother, sister. So when you see about these words or when you hear about these words, you come to know what are the masculine and feminine. Shepherd, shepherdess, rooster, hen. Now what is rooster here? It is known as also a cock. But here we are learning a new word, that is rooster. Dog is a masculine and bitch is a feminine. Bull is a male category and cow is a female category. Drone and bee. Gander and goose. Stag and hen. Gentleman, lady, or we can say it as gentlewoman. Count, countess. Husband, wife. Lord, lady. King, monk. Sir, madam. Uncle, aunt. Nephew, niece. Wizard, witch. Hart, roe. Drake, duck. Lion, lioness. So you can see here there are various examples that are telling us about masculine and feminine gender. So with these examples, I hope you are trying to understand what is masculine and feminine gender. There are some new words that you must have come across. So I request you to take a dictionary and find out the meaning of those words and write it in your notebook as you are going to do these assignments in your notebook. Now let us see what are the other things that falls in this same category. Correct? Like priest, priestess, prophet, prophetess. Now what is prophet? One who tells something about the future. So that is called prophetess or prophet. Patron, patroness, host, hostess, viscount or viscountess, steward, stewardess, heir, heiress, baron, baroness, peer, peeress, abbot, abbess, emperor, empress, traitor, traitress, actor, actress, poet, poetess, benefactor, benefactress, Tom, Quinn, Stalin, mayor, ram, ewe, fox, vixen, tiger, tigress, buck, doe, boar, sow. So you can see here there are various new examples that we have come across as we are learning this, correct? So for example, let us understand what is a emperor. So emperor is something who is king and empress is a queen. Priest, we know the male category of person who is performing puja in the temple, we call it priest. And similar, the female who are serving God in the temples, they are known as priestess. For example, we can call as monk and nun. If you remember, we have learned in this fourth standard. So there are various examples that I am giving you in order to understand the masculine and the feminine things. Now let us see the another example. Okay. So what is here? You can see hunter and huntress. Do you see that? What exactly you understand by word hunter? Yes or no? Correct. The one who hunts. Tempter, temptress. Master, mistress. Duke, duchess. Enchanter. What is enchanter? The one who sings, the one who praises God in the temple. Enchantress. Songster, songstress. Hero, heroine. Sultan, sultana. Caesar. See the spelling of Caesar here? C-Z-A-R, Caesar. And the female is Caesarian. Senior, it's a person, or signora. Manservant, maidservant. He-goat, she-goat. Cock sparrow, hen sparrow. Bull calf, cow calf. Grandfather, grandmother. Landlord, landlady. Milkman, milkmaid. Peacock, peahen. Giant, giantess. So here you can see the various examples I have given with the pictures in order to understand the masculine and feminine gender of a noun. So in this way you come to know what exactly is a masculine and feminine gender. I hope you have understood with this examples that I have shown you in the picture. So now let us move on towards common gender. Common gender, a noun or pronoun that can either be female or male. Understand here what is common gender? It could be either male or female. See the here example I have given. Parent, it could be your mother or father, anything we are talking about. Child, student, servant, friend, cousin, member, teacher, they, them. So here you see there are two pronouns I have used, they and them. So it could be anything, correct? When we are talking about a group, in that group there are both man and women. But in order to differentiate them as a one group, we call it they. So cousin could be your brother or sister. Member could be anything. You can see the other example also, like a driver. It could be a girl who is driving or a boy. Do you understand? A lawyer. So here in this category, whatever the occupation are available in this world, that could be done by the male or female. So like we have engineers, we have doctors, correct? So, or a train ticket collector. It could be anything that has possibility of being a male and a female. So that is why we say it as common gender. So the vocabulary also you will come to know as you will do the exercise which we have provided to you after this video. So common gender is nothing but having a both. It could be both male and female. But how we are differentiating? By calling a child. Correct? Or a student or a servant. So this is about a common gender. It is very easy to understand. Now let us move on towards neuter gender. Neuter gender means, okay, it is not neutral. Understand what is the wrong idea we have? It is not a neutral. It is a noun or pronoun that is either neither female nor male. Okay, so in a simple thing I'll tell you, it is nothing but a non-living things. We cannot differentiate it into a male or a female category. Let us see the example. Room, chair, pen, tree, book, star, lake, car, it, paper. So it is lifeless things. Okay, so that is why we call it as neuter gender. Here you cannot see as exactly, correct? Here we cannot differentiate whether a pen is a male or a female. Correct? So all the non-living things comes under this category. Have you understood what is neuter gender? Yes. So it is about all the non-living things which comes under this category. There are other examples also. We can say laptop, computer, hard drive, mobile. This all comes under this neuter gender. Do you understand, my dear students? Okay, it's very easy to understand this topic. There are four types of gender, that is masculine, feminine, common and neuter. So I hope you have understood this topic and do the exercise which I have given to you on the base of this chapter. Thank you.